Welcome back, mineralogy fans. It's a big episode today as we come to the last of the seven major mineral groups, the native element minerals, which have an orderly arrangement of atoms of one element. As a quick rundown of the elements on the periodic table that can form crystallized minerals, we have aluminum, antimony, arsenic, bismuth, carbon, cadmium, chromium, copper, gold, indium, iron, iridium, lead, mercury, if you get it down below negative 38 C, nickel, osmium, palladium, platinum, rhenium, rhodium, selenium, silver, silicon, sulfur, tantalum, tellurium, tin, titanium, vanadium, and zinc. We won't cover all of these in detail, but it would be remiss of me to be at the Colorado School of Mines and not mention copper, silver, gold, palladium, and platinum, all of which display metallic luster and form with the sulfides in hydrothermal deposits or in some igneous rocks. Copper is at a hardness of 2.5 to 3 and is usually copper-colored, though browns to red are possible. It has a rose-colored streak and oxidizes to the familiar green patina. The specific gravity is 8.94, which is the highest density mineral we have seen so far, so its mass gives clue to the copper's identity. The name comes from Cyprus, cupros, which was the principal source of copper in ancient Greece. It can be used for decorative purposes and loves to grow in dendritic crystal form, meaning branching like a tree. Industrially, copper is used in the electronics world due to copper's ability to conduct heat and electricity well, and because copper is ductile, that is, it can be drawn out into wires. So copper is a common metal of electrical wiring. Alloyed with tin, it becomes bronze, and thus took humans out of the Stone Age. From ancient to modern times, copper has been used for coinage as well. Malleable, you can pound it into thin sheets. Sectile, you can cut it with a knife. And ductile, you can draw it into wires. Resistance to corrosion and ease of being alloyed with other minerals are valued properties for copper and all of our following metallic native element minerals. And as we go, we'll have even greater resistance to corrosion. Silver has one more property copper doesn't, which puts it into a whole new category known as the precious metals. That extra property is rarity. Silver and the other precious metals are much rarer than copper, so you are not likely to encounter the native precious metals in nature unless you're trained to know where to look. But if you do happen to see them, maybe at an estate sale or something, you should be prepared to identify them. The precious metals include silver, gold, platinum, and palladium. Silver is a mineral name that has more clouded origins, and in many of its past uses has been synonymous with money. The earliest possible origin is from Acadium, Sarpu, which came from Sarapu, meaning to smelt and refine. With a characteristic gray to gray-white to silver color, about the only other test needed is picking it up, as we have a new specific gravity record holder at 10 to 11 times the density of water, though we'll find later we still need to distinguish from palladium by its hardness. Like copper, it has a hardness of 2.5 to 3, so it leaves a streak which is silver, white, in color, and you're just going to have to trust me on that because I don't want to waste my silver. Besides silverware and jewelry, silver has a few other uses. Silver paints are used for printed circuits, and silver leaf is used in mirrors due to its high reflectivity, though as any of us know with real silverware, it does tarnish due to oxidation over time. Silver is used for electrical contacts and solder, in batteries, and as a brazing alloy. Mineral silver crystals can grow in massive, dendritic, or wiry crystal habit. This wire silver is associated with calcite crystals, which happen to be fluorescent under UV light. Neither silver nor any of the other precious metals fluoresce under UV light, but the next precious metal will fluoresce under X-ray light. Gold is the most famous of the precious metals and can be identified and its purity determined by X-ray fluorescence. The name gold has been variously associated with root words meaning to shine or yellow due to its characteristic golden yellow color and highly reflective metallic luster. Coming in at 19.3 times more dense than water, we have our new heavyweight champion in gold. So the color and mass pretty much give this mineral away. Anyone who has watched a show about gold mining and sedimentary deposits know that shakers and pans are used to eject the less dense minerals while the dense gold stays behind. Gold, as with copper and silver, has a hardness of 2.5 to 3 and can leave a streak showing the gold color. Nope, not gonna demonstrate that either. We discussed in the sulfide minerals how to tell pyrite or fool's gold from real gold, and you can refer back to that for differences. Gold can take on a range of crystal forms when it grows large enough to see, but most gold is scattered through their ore rocks, and the decision to mine such ore is dependent on the concentration of gold in the ore, ease of mining the ore, ease of extracting the gold or other precious metals from the ore without significant pollutants, and the current price. Gold has been used for jewelry and coinage for a long time, both in relatively pure and alloyed states, and obviously continues to be so. Malleable, ductile, sectile, conductive of electricity, easily alloyed with the other metals, and much more resistant to corrosion, explains its wide array of uses, including in electronics as wires, relay contacts, switches, connectors, CPUs, and computer chips. So whether you are watching this on a computer or a mobile device, the information is being passed along by gold components in your device. There is a treatment for arthritis involving the injection of dissolved gold salts, a cure for a rare condition where people are unable to close their eyes completely, in which gold compounds are placed in the eyelids to weigh them down, and gold can protect us from harmful radiation, even in very thin sheets. Gold polyesters on the exterior of some spacecraft help regulate surface temperatures by rejecting radiation. The malleability means you can take a small amount and spread it over a large area, and many objects and structures use gold leafing. And the winner is the Gold Palace in India. Union Station in Washington, D.C. only gets a Grammy. Oh, it's also used in dentistry. I've got to have my grill on while I'm cold lamping about my Mother Earth in full effect. But how much more dope to be kicking a platinum grill? Heavy. In fact, this silvery metallic precious metal is almost twice the density of silver, coming in at a calculated specific gravity of 21.47. But most samples of platinum come in closer to gold's 19 times the weight of water. All the other precious metals are about the hardness of calcite at 2.5 to 3, but platinum is closer to fluorite at 4 to 4.5. It will leave a silvery streak, which is a waste of platinum, when the density would give it away if you had a piece big enough to do a streak test with. As with gold, this density is used to sort it from stream sediments, and the name platinum comes from the Spanish plata, for a river in which it was found. This metal, too, has been used as coinage and jewelry for millennia, and you might think that having all the great properties of gold, it would have about the same uses. Platinum, however, is mostly used in catalytic converters of our cars and trucks, so if you're watching this while driving, don't. But besides you're using it to regulate the pollution from your favorite form of transportation, platinum is also used as a catalyst to make benzene, nitric acid, and silicone. We use platinum as part of chemotherapy drugs to fight cancers, and it is involved in the manufacture of wind turbine engines, LCD screens, and computer hard disks, oxygen sensors, thermocouples, spark plugs, and yes, platinum is used in dentistry, so I can get my dope grill, G. Yeah, boy. And you can measure how dope that is because the original standard for a meter was defined by a platinum rod. And the standard for a kilogram is still defined by a platinum mass. And platinum is used as a standard hydrogen electrode to measure relative reduction oxidation potential of other materials. Or you can measure time in some of the most sophisticated watches whose components include platinum parts, which neither corrode nor wear down as easily as gold. And that second quality is another big leg up on those other precious metals, which will wear down rather easily if used as mechanical parts. According to the Advanced D&D Player's Handbook, first edition from 1978, the relative value of copper to gold is 200 copper pieces equal 1 gold piece. Silver only takes a tenth of that, 20 silver pieces, to equal 1 gold piece. There's some electrum in there, which is an alloy of gold, silver, and copper, so we'll pass by that, and see that it takes 5 gold pieces to equal 1 platinum piece. Many role-playing fans are quite certain platinum is more valuable than gold, but as of 2015, when I'm making this, copper is about 17 cents per ounce, silver is at $16 per ounce, gold is $1,180 per ounce, and platinum is $1,125 per ounce. So I guess since the time I was fighting and training dragons and laying siege to my friends' castles, the relative values of these native element minerals has changed. Or not. And the player's handbook doesn't even have our last precious metal mineral, palladium, which is presently valued at $775 per ounce. This one is a bit harder to tell from silver, as it too has a silver metallic luster and a specific gravity around 11, but we can differentiate by its hardness, which is well above the 2.5 to 3 of silver, with palladium coming in at a hardness of 4.5 to 5, closer to apatite. Palladium is more elastic than ductile too, but still ends up in many of the same uses as silver and gold. And that covers the precious metals, but we are not done with the native elements yet. When we come back next time, we finish off the native elements and end our tour of the major mineral groups when we find out what nature can order up from sulfur and carbon on our menu.